He's tossing for the break.
Hi. Tossing or lagging? They tossed.
And he won. And he, so he's got the break.
Winner, winner. Okay, next match, folks. We want to welcome you guys back to the West Coast Swing. And we are at Freezer's Ice House for the Freezer's Ice House One Pocket Challenge, sponsored by West State Billiards at weststatebilliards.com. And also by Big Time Threads and by JB Cases. And also by these wonderful cue makers, Eddie Cohen, Ariel Carmelli, Kent Davis, and Tiger Products. Also, special thanks to Billiards Boulevard. We're starting this match right now. It is Warren Kiamko, who just scratched on the break, Carla.
I can't believe it. This is a winner's side. Each of these have won, I think, two or three matches.
They both have two matches.
Two wins, and this is, yeah.
This is their third match of the day. The winner of this match will go home for the day. So here's Tony off of the break, off of, this is not good for Warren to relinquish the break that quickly.
Warren had to fight for 4 hours with Hurtcheck.
Yeah.
And now he's got the... this freight now, train coming now, at him. Yeah, look at him. He's going to move these two.
Yeah. Now it could just be 15 minutes with Tony.
Nice how he did that, huh?
See how
gentle he did that?
Well, he also hit that very thin, which I think helps, you know.
But stop the rock. Want to say hello to One Pocket Rich and Don Henderson, who are over at Santa Monica House of Billiards watching this.
Hey, Rich Grenier and Don Henderson. Man, I'd love to have Rich here doing commentary.
Except for the swear words. He's awfully good.
I think he's past that. He's okay now. You know, we had a talk. He's good. He's good. You know, that whole experience, it shied him away from the microphone for almost 2-3 years.
Well, I don't know if that's what shied him away, but... he was awfully good in the booth that night.
He was good. It's just that, you know.
Plus, he knows exactly what the right shot to shoot.
I had silliness on my live stream from a chat room. You know, there were people saying that he shouldn't be swearing.
Well,
I don't know. I think I cowered under pressure. I should have kept him on.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. He was one of the best.
So anyway, let's get back to this. Tony Chohan is the winner of the West Coast Challenge One Pocket this year. He just ran over the whole field. Nothing stopping this guy right now from my perspective. How about you?
Well, Warren can be relentless, too. He's going to be real safe and real careful. I'm not going to make any move too soon. But it's... if you don't keep Tony in the chair, you're in trouble.
That's true. It's hard to keep Tony in the chair in one pocket, though.
Yes. So, I guess he's going to come off the 5 and go underneath the 12.
I'm hearing some sweating going on the rail here. There's some odds being thrown around and sweating going on.
3-1. If a Filipino's getting 3-1, then that's amazing.
Well, if you ask me, scratch on the break against Tony Chohan. He got off real cheap here. He only lost.
Yeah.
He only lost a ball here. He owes one ball, but you know.
But he lost his position. There's two balls by Tony's hole now.
Yeah, so there's a little bit of strength to his side, but...
he's got to figure out a way to get below it without selling out the 9-ball bank.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, he had a dead ball.
Wow, he hit a, very nice shot. Made one for Tony and for Warren.
Mm-hmm. Wow. He might get a few here.
He may.
Oh,
Well, he's pretty straight on this nine.
Mm-hmm. So, he can draw it back and try to shove the whole rack over there, or he could follow it around.
Yeah, there is that strategy, isn't there? Well, what about backing up and trying to maybe somehow get on that 12 ball up table?
Yeah, well, if you can back up, you could just move the whole rack over towards your hole. You know, the 10, 11, 6 off the 8 might go.
Sure. I think he's drawing for the 12. You know, see how much spin he put on that ball?
Does the 14 go?
No, I don't think the 14. I don't know, but remember there was another shot like that that Warren played and didn't look like it would go, and it did.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm not going to guess.
Is this cue ball lighter or different
the
than
measle
the
ball?
Measle ball that hard times? Because it looks like a draw is quite
You mean,
easier.
Is this measle ball what? Lighter than the other measle balls at hard times?
What measle ball is this that they're playing with here?
I believe the measle ball is an Aramith product. You know, there are fake measle balls out there, but I don't think Scott Frost's room is using...
So these are Aramith balls?
Yeah,
that using?
Yeah, these are Aramith. I believe they're tournament pros. That's what they look like to me.
Mm-hmm. Feels different than the ones at hard times.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, they're not the TV balls that we see with the brown seven.
See how he did that off the eight?
Yeah, yeah. Brushed off the eight real nice.
Now he's got to spot his up, and it'll be 2-1 Tony.
Yes, sir.
Wait, he didn't spot up the one
no.
he owes.
2-1 Warren. You mean?
2-1 Warren.
Yeah.
Move your penny. There you go.
When are we going to play, Carla?
10-4 in the break.
Oh, my God. As good as you commentate?
Unless I can have someone do the shooting for me.
10-4 in the breaks.
Yeah.
Sheesh.
I've seen your stroke. You shoot good.
Yeah, but you don't have to lock me in.
I hate to play. I hate to play.
I feel stuck already.
I hate to play people that run out, run a lot of balls. I prefer people that run two balls and stop. Like me. He's going to make this off the six. No, he didn't make it.
No, a double kiss.
Oh, he might sell out the
11. Cue ball.
Well, he sold out the 12 either way, so he's in trouble either way.
Yeah.
Now, does he play this 12 off the 8 or into the 14? Watch this.
You'd have to play it into the 14.
Well, he played it off the 8. He missed it off the 8, but still. Nice duck.
Well, Warren can play this off the stack now if he wants. Or
I don't know,
into the 6.
Can he see enough of it to...
I think he can. Yeah. Actually, though, it's a pretty acute angle.
If he plays it off the 3 or the 15, he can hide that cue ball right behind the 11.
If he plays this at all, if he banks it into the 6, he'll have to play the cue ball around table 3 rails.
Yeah. Looks like that's what he's going to do.
No, no, no. He likes...
Oh, he went the other way, but he
duck.
Didn't... Oh, he didn't duck
He didn't.
It.
And he needed to duck under that 11. Mm-hmm. That's what he needed to do. Now
the machine gun is coming at him.
Yeah. So if he would have ducked under that 11, he would have put Tony in a lot of trouble.
Yeah, with several balls on his side.
Yeah, yeah. You know, Tony can do the same thing with the 6, but it's not as effective. It's not as effective as Warren's doing it.
Because Warren had balls on his side.
Yeah, he did.
Tony played all cue ball there, and he made it in the side.
He did.
By accident.
Now, Like it or not, I think Warren still has a shot to play the nine ball. He can bank, or the one ball, I mean.
Where is it?
Looks like he can bank that one ball.
I don't know, the six might have him.
Maybe. No, he's shooting on it.
He's kicking behind the 11.
No, he's not.
Oh, you're right.
Oh, he just played. He's
playing the cue ball behind the 11, or trying to, yeah. Nice shot.
Boy, the table's rolling slow, I think.
What time of day is it? Is it raining out? It looks dark out there.
It's 5:30 p.m. according to my time.
So it's not, it shouldn't be dark yet. Looks like a storm's coming, huh?
Possibly. Yeah. It is getting dark later with the summer hours. Mm-hmm.
Nice shot. Oh, but I can see Tony smoking this six ball back. Oh no, the 14. Anything on his side too much.
Shooting into the stack, Carla.
The two ball. I mean the 10 ball, yeah. Well, now he's got something in front of his hole, anyway.
Yeah.
Score is 2-1, Warren. This is the first game.
Yeah.
Race to 3, winner's side.
It's actually going on a lot longer than I expected it to.
No.
Especially with Warren, he scratched on the break in this, you know, in this game.
Yeah.
I think he wants to kick under the ball and try to bring the 10 towards his hole. But there's no point in that. You got the 8 and the 14 are blockers, right? They won't allow those balls to.
Or the 15-3 banking that across, but I don't think it's a clear shot. Plus, you got this ball hanging in Warren's hole.
I know. And then he's even going to take a look at the 6. Might as well. It's there, you know. So that's one thing I admire about Tony's game. He looks at every shot, and he does it very quickly, too.
Get that out of there a little.
Yeah. It's nice to be here at Freezer's Ice House, watching the best players in the world.
Well, what's he gonna do here?
Good question.
Could just skim off the 8 and go to the side rail over there.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, it's subtle, but you know the way that 10 ball has just been bumped toward the side. Now Tony has like a little extra space to hide next shot, so that's why Warren's like making sure he doesn't just like, you know, think he's safe. He's got to be safe. Right?
Yeah.
Playing Tony.
I guess maybe he's just going to follow the 11, try to freeze it on the 15. Oh, he played something. I don't understand.
Oh. Well, you know what?
That was a good shot,
though. He's okay, though. Yeah. He's actually in very good shape here.
He would have been out if he made it. There's 6 balls there, you know.
Yeah. If the 3 wasn't there, Tony would be looking at this 4-ball bank. What's he looking at then? What is he doing?
Moving the 10.
No,
oh,
he's
going
just
under.
Yeah, he just see how that when the 10 ball moved, that gave him space. It gave him space, more places to hide.
You're right. He's got to get him underneath the 14 some way.
Yeah, maybe off the 3.
He's a billiard player. He knows how to do this. Perfect.
That's where he wanted to get, like,
exactly.
5 shots ago.
Mm-hmm. Now, what's Tony going to do?
You know.
Bank it something?
Yeah, he might bank it the 15 here.
Or do something tricky.
I mean, what's tricky here, Carla? Do you see anything tricky? Double up.
Yeah, you could
Can you double something else?
Yeah, but the 10 is like hanging his big ball off the rail. So.
Yeah.
Well, he's going to draw it behind the... He's going to draw this behind the 10.
Look, he got there.
Nothing to it.
Didn't have to go behind so much as he went close. You know what I like here? Well, no, I don't know if I like it. Never mind.
1 rail the 2 or 2 rail the 6?
No, I was going to say if he could get his cue ball up behind that 6 ball. But I like 2 rail the 6. It's not a bad idea.
Or 1 rail the 2. Why
yeah,
not?
The two's in there as well.
Oh, he's just going to duck. Oh.
That's why he's up there.
Yes, he's thinking like Efren a little bit more than just trying to make one ball.
Yeah.
He wants to make all the balls. Yeah, take that.
Yeah, it doesn't bother Tony at all.
No, not at all. So he can't make anything. He's got nothing.
No, he doesn't have anything. I'm just so impressed by Tony's ability to come up with something that's so simple and so quick.
So fast, yeah.
You know.
He can't get past the 1 to hit the 13. It's hooked on the 1. He could bank the 1 toward his hole and just stay right there. Then Tony could cut at the 4, let him do it.
What was the score of Schuff's match? Was it hill or
3-1?
3-1, yeah.
He should have got to the hill. He was ahead that second game or the third game.
Joe Swick in the chat room was asking. He said we had a power outage. What was the match score?
What town is he in with a power outage?
Yeah, I don't know. Not sure, Carla.
David Hardtime says they're sweating there. He said it's hot there.
Dave Scooter Dave.
Yeah.
I call him Scooter. You'd probably know his whole name, but I'm sure he'd like Scooter Dave too.
Yeah.
Well, that's going to...
Can't see the two.
No, it's going to be difficult here for Warren. How about... see, I think he's trying to test him, you know, like shoot the six. I don't like shooting the six, though. You know, shoot one rail to six, maybe like into the 11. I don't know if it would go to the pocket. I think the four might be in the way. No,
you,
I think
you don't want to leave Tony with a shot at the four. Though.
Right, exactly. That's why he's trying to he's like teasing him, you know.
What if you bank the four toward your hole and bring the cue ball all the way down here? Try not to scratch.
I like that, except that the way he'd have to do it, he may actually double kiss the four.
Mm.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because he'd be crossing the four.
Well, then play all the cue ball then.
Yeah.
Go ahead and cross the four and come down to the end.
He's trying to figure out, like, what...
He's stuck on that 12.
Yeah. How about this? Just thin the 12, play the cue ball down to the bottom rail here.
Yeah.
That's not easy, but...
It's easier to thin the 6 or the 4.
Yeah, just thin the 6.
I'd like to move that 4, though, because that's a ball for Tony to shoot, you know?
You know what? You're right. Yup.
He's just going to tuck him behind the 12.
100%.
Like. Don't do anything. Just tuck him.
Well, I think he's a couple inches off the rail. It's not such an easy tuck.
He's trying to put Tony to sleep.
How about this? Just, you don't try to bank the four toward your hole. You just bank it 1-2 rails back up table.
Okay.
You know?
And then do just what with the cue ball? Bring it all the way down?
Well.
Or bring it, stop it right where it is. Then you're
stop it right
up
where it is, but then you're, well, yeah, you could double up on the two.
2 and 10, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. I like that shot. And he actually could try to draw back behind the six. Do you see what I'm saying?
Yeah, but you have to hit it off hard to draw it behind
okay.
the 6.
He's going to draw behind the 12. All right, I'm not going to guess at this point. I'm done guessing. He's got way higher vocabulary in this game than I do, so.
So Tony's standing up now to watch.
Yup.
He was sleeping in the chair, and then he saw Warren making a move.
Yeah, I know.
Like he might take the shot.
Yeah, He's taking...
He must be going to go behind the 12, because otherwise, what's he doing? Oh, he's going for his hole. Look at this.
Look at this,
he made
it goes.
See, I think that's the good hole there.
That was a great shot.
Well, now he doubled himself up on the 210, though.
No, you said that was the bad hole earlier.
No, this is the good hole. Oh, wait, you're right. That is... That. You're
you
right,
said
so it wasn't a hole
you said
at all.
Yeah.
You're paying too much attention.
Carlo, the ratings are going down. We're losing our ratings, man.
I can't figure out what the good
fake
hole
news,
is.
Oh. Fake news on POV Pool. Bob Herchick's a good cue maker. When it was really Joel Herchick.
Bob Herchick is a good player.
He's a good player, but he's not a good cue maker. Don't get it twisted.
All right. Well, we got that over with, and it's 3-1.
Yeah.
Warren. Warren's got the 3-1.
Yeah. He'd like to one
and
rail this 15.
On the break, and he's still winning 3-1 against the world's
world,
best.
Probably the world's best, yeah. Arguably the world's best one pocket player right now.
Yeah.
In this unit of time.
I don't know who would argue it the other way.
Yeah.
Since they want 4-1 on the money.
Yes.
All right, let's see something fancy.
My bet's on Chohan for this whole tournament.
Against the field?
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I didn't make a bet. Mm-hmm. If anybody wants to make a bet, there's still time. Geraldine says make a bet. All right, I bet you.
She's taking the field.
You get the field. I get Tony.
49 people.
5-1 on the money. I get 5-1 on the money.
Even money.
Oh, really? I don't know. It's your 5-1. No, it's my 5-1, isn't it?
You can't have Chohan and 5-1.
Okay. So if you lose, you owe me 50.
Look, he played that. Look what he did. He played that off there. Got all the balls by his hole.
Geraldine said she'll just pay the utilities.
She's tricky.
I'm telling you, man, I get hustled left and right.
But as long as you're having fun, that's the main thing.
Pool Hustler 6 wants to bet me. I want 5-1.
He wants to take the field, but yeah. He wants odds too?
Yeah.
Wow.
Geraldine bet. That's because she's kind of cray-cray.
Look what he did. He kicked it in.
Hi, Warren. Oh, nice shot. Man. Warren Kiyomko.
He's been watching the Efren Reyes tape.
Geraldine says Warren's the one to do it. Warren is the one. He is the one to stop Tony Chohan.
Well, he could put him in the loser bracket right here if he wins 3 games. One, two, three, four.
Oh, now Geraldine's all into this game.
You want to raise it now?
Man.
She's going to get a Warren Kiyomko t-shirt, hat. How old is Warren Kiyomko?
Warren Kiyomko. I think he's 42.
Really?
Again. I think he's 42 again.
Looks like he has more miles on him than that.
Be nice.
Oh.
Oh! Okay, a lot of awes going on.
What's he got, 6?
They should just call this game. Oh! What?
Oh, he needed 1.
He needs 1. That was his game ball.
So Tony's going to go for the 12 and the 9 and the 10.
Yeah, he's just going to run out from here. That rolled off.
Yeah.
It rolled off.
I thought he was going to slam it, you know? All right, no. That's 1 game for Warren Kiyomko.
He hit it slow because he wanted to play for the next shot and get a good cue ball. But all right, so here we go, 1-0, and I'm calling off all bets now.
Oh, you lose 1 game and you've changed your whole
strategy. No, I just don't. I won't bet with anybody online right now because I can't. You know, I'm the broadcaster. I can't
do any.
You
gotta pay attention.
No, I'm not allowed to do any online betting. It's.
I don't blame you.
It's not legal.
So, all right, here we go. This is our break, and I understand
if
you make
in-house in-house wagering is fine.
If you make a ball on the break here, you get to keep on going, huh? Don't have to spot it up if you make a ball on this
turn. No, there's no.
I like that better. I don't like it where it comes back up. Well, he's going to try to get behind the 7 here.
Oh, boy.
And he did.
Yeah, I think Warren's kind of getting in stroke now.
But that doesn't get him out of the woods here.
No, not against Tony. No way. No way, Jose. Jeff Gregory up in the house. What's up, Jeff?
He's just going to go off its side and get here on the side of the rack. Oh, it came way down. I thought he was going to stick on the side of the rack. He's a little sleepy, I think. Somebody's asking for 9-6. Are they asking you or someone else?
They're asking Chris Cash for 9-6. So I must know who Pool Hustler 6 is because he knows Chris Cash. Just don't remember who Pool Hustler 6 is.
Whoever he is, he's asking for 9-6. So
asking Chris Cash for 9-6?
So he's a pool hustler.
Yeah, no kidding.
Now what's Warren going to do here? Try to get behind the 7 again?
Yeah, maybe like the same shot that he tried last inning, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Thin it to win it, you know? Bring it under the...
He hit it really thin.
He did. Little,
really thin.
Yeah, and it still didn't...
Oh, he's going to hit this one a little bit.
Doesn't have to hit this as thin.
Came out and came behind it. Wow. He left. And he cut off.
Did you see how quick Tony? No, he didn't cut nothing off. He's got
off
a bank.
One.
He's got a bank. Tony's banking. Shooting right at this. Come on now.
There's one down.
Yep.
He got a combination here or what? The 9 doesn't go by the 13. Sit down, Warren.
You're rooting for Warren, huh?
No, I told... I can't root
you
against
want,
Tony.
You won't get...
Tony's
oh, you can't
hero.
Root against Tony?
He's my hero.
He's your hero. That's right. He's your hero. But is there a story behind this?
No, I just... just amazing. I'm amazed.
You've been watching him a lot lately, huh? All the stuff we've been streaming?
Yes.
Yeah, he's definitely on point with this game. Definitely knows what's up.
But also his competence level. He's just so competent.
Yeah. Yeah. He doesn't get rattled, like, at all.
Getting behind him again. What about this 212? Does this 212 kick in? The 212 off the 7?
I'm not sure. I'm not sure. If anybody knows it, it would be Tony.
Yeah. He's looking the other way, so... So, Tony shot at his hole, leaving Warren on the other side, on the wrong side of the pack. Warren could, but if he plays this shot, what is he going to do with the 13-6? Just leave it there? Looks like he wants to play it. And I guess brought to the end rail. Well, you better move that 13-6. I think you better move the 13 and 6. Just draw it back. Yeah. Now he's still got this kick. Or he could bank the 6 or the 1. Going for the kick. He did it softly. Didn't get the kiss. Still, I don't think he sold anything out. Looks like he's got a dead one with the 8 off the 15. Score is 1-0, Warren Kemco. And Tony's got 1-0. Looks like he's playing this dead ball. Putting the cue ball down there behind the 10 or 12. Nice shot.
He's fine.
Looks like Kemco can see this 12 ball, but I don't think he can bank it.
What I miss, Carla? What I miss?
Well, just a little moving. Got quite a few balls by Tony's side, though. So Warren's got to keep ducking. Well, he didn't get that one down far enough.
Well, Tony has a look at this 3, but he's got to stay away from... He may have to stay away from it because of the 8 ball.
Plus, it doesn't really go. You have to play the combination, huh?
Combo bank?
Yeah. I'm not sure what he did there.
Yeah, I think.
Did he play the 8 cue ball safe from the 8? I guess he did.
Yeah, but still, I think it might have been a little bit of a brain fart because he didn't protect himself on that shot either.
Right. The trouble with Warren playing nice and slow is Tony loses his
rhythm,
focus, or rhythm, or energy, or whatever
it
is.
Yeah. 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 But Warren definitely
Arcolo does that too. He plays so slow and looks at everything so much mm-hmm. that it puts a faster player out of their rhythm.
Thing about Arcolo though is, I think a lot of times he's doing that because he actually doesn't know the shot. He's like, Warren. On many occasions, he knows the shot. He's just making
sure. He knows more than Arcolo.
Yeah, and he's looking more, at what's there. He knows more than Arcolo. And I know I'm saying a lot right now by saying that. I'm risking a lot of criticism, but I still think Dennis is figuring out one pocket.
Yes.
Whereas Warren has a lot of years of of he's got miles on this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. So he just rolled out Dom there. And what has Warren got? The 7 ball into the 8. He's got to decide whether to shoot that combination and sell out the game if he wants to make it. Looks like it's an easy enough combination, though, doesn't it? The 7-8? 8
well,
like a tiny bit off the rail?
Yeah, but Warren knows not to shoot a shot that he can miss.
I don't know. I think he's going to shoot it and come down for the 4.
No, I think the 8 goes straight in.
No, I think he's got to shoot the 7 into the 8. If the 8 goes straight in, he can't get on the next ball. I think he's going to play the combination.
You think so?
Yeah.
See?
Oh, so he missed it.
I told you, Carla, that shot, it carries a lot of risk. It's yes. Just
although the 7, the 10, 11 doesn't, it blocks Tony's hole, so he's going to have to move that 7.
No, he combinates this.
I don't know.
He combinates the 10, 11.
Off the 12? Or?
I bet you a buck he combinates it.
I'll bet you a buck he doesn't.
You mean you'll take me on that bet?
Well, here goes the crazy man. You're right. Oh, no, he's not going for it. Oh, he is going for it.
I told you.
I guess that's a safe bet, betting $1 that Tony will go for his hole.
For Tony to not go for the money in the stack is almost like...
Here, let me just give you this dollar right now.
Yeah.
But he's got to cut it backwards, so what's he going to play shape on?
He's already over the edge. He's not going to change his mind. He's jumped off the cliff already. He's shooting this all day. All day. Even if it takes him all day to shoot it, he's going to shoot it.
I would fire that 7 ball into the back of the 8 and clear that whole side and make something in my hole.
Yeah. Geraldine, she does make a good point, though. She says that Warren Kiyomko is the reason.
Well, look what he did with the cue ball. Oh, no.
Not good enough. Not good enough.
Well, I don't know. Does the 4 go?
Maybe not. Maybe not.
What does Geraldine say?
She says that Warren Kiyomko is one of the reasons she would take the field against Tony Chohan.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but one of the
what
only
about
reasons.
Alex and Dennis?
Alex and Dennis are here,
and,
too.
What's his name? Josh Roberts.
I know. That's why I want 5-1.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not, you know.
No, I mean, the field
I'm
is.
I'm not giving my money away.
The field is 5-1.
Yeah.
I mean, more than 5-1.
I know.
The thing about Tony is if he doesn't play safe, he can get beat.
Did Tony scratch at some point? Because I don't see any balls in the tray anymore. I did step away for a minute. So it's 0-0 now.
I don't recall him scratching. Oh, yeah, he did. He rolled out
yeah,
up
he
there.
He had a ball. He had a ball in his trap earlier.
Yeah. He rolled out to the end rail somewhere.
Yeah. That's so funny that Warren would reach down and put that ball in the trap now when he's about to run probably 5 more.
He's checking to make sure that it's what the score is, you know, before he starts.
Yeah, yeah.
Knows how many he's got to make.
Sure.
Geez, this could be... It's 1-0 right now. This could be 2-0.
Yeah, he can run out.
Mm-hmm.
He came and played, I think, in 1997.
Warren Kiemko did?
He went. He won the. Or was it 2003? I don't know why I'm getting those 2 years mixed up. He won the Andy Mercer, the Rum Runner tournament, and I believe it was under a different name.
Huh.
But when they stuck his name on the trophy, they put the right name. And also, you know, Warren won the Mercer this year too.
Did he?
Yeah, he double dipped Shane Van Boning.
Wow. So he's having a great year.
Oh, he's having a very good year.
Well, I think he wanted to hit the two there. Now he might not get out. He's got five. He needs three. He wanted to tip that two a little bit. Now he's a long ways away and straight in. Oh, he's gonna bank this. That'll work. He's out. That's gonna be 2-0. Yep, 2-0. And he's breaking. He should have an upset here. So you took Tony and Geraldine took the field, right?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Geraldine is a...
That's all right. I don't mind.
Well, it's not over yet, but...
Losing $10 to Geraldine, to me, is, you know, just like she said, if she loses, she'll pay a utility bill. If I lose, I'll get her Starbucks.
2-0.
2-0.
And breaking.
Yeah, we got action. Action for Warren, that's for sure.
See the 10, so it's not the greatest break. And he made the 10.
Nope, stayed there.
It's all right.
So, I like Warren to kick this in, but...
Yeah.
Scott Frost is sweating some action from the bleachers.
Yeah. I think there might be some big action here tonight. There's some backers wandering around.
I see
some big money around, yes.
You recognize some faces?
Yep.
See if you can get me backed in something.
Okay.
Hoo-yah! Come on, I'll take 13-4 from Tony.
You need it.
Huh?
You need it.
Come on, you don't think I can beat him 13-4, 12-4,
12-4? Every time, you know, you can run four balls pretty good.
12-4? I think I could do it. He ain't giving me that weight, though.
Well, Warren hid this 10 and... What's he going to do now? Is he going to shoot the whole twang the whole stack over there. This is case game for him. It's 2-0. Look what he's going to do.
Well, it's case game for yeah.
If he breaks this open and doesn't make it.
Let's take a look. There's another camera angle, too.
Oh, he made it?
He played a nice little...
Mm-hmm.
He babied it in.
Yeah. Now what?
Well, now it's worth one more ball, that's for sure. But knowing Tony...
He's not happy with one
I don't
more.
Like try... I tell you... As much as I've been watching Tony lately in the past year and a half, I don't like predicting his game. I don't like predicting what he's going to do.
Well, he wants to make this 7 and go over and move that 14 so that he can shoot the...
I mean, I'm getting better at calling his shots, but I'm just... It's way... there's times when I'm just
Watch
way
him
off
because I... 14. Oh, he didn't. Maybe he can bank the 14.
Yeah, he can bank the 14. See how well he played that shot?
Mm-hmm.
He just like he looked all overextended and dorky, and he still played exactly what he needed to do.
It's pretty tight.
Oh, he can miss it too, and that wouldn't be good. Case game, right?
No, it's fine if he misses
wow.
it.
Wow.
He's just so gentle.
And he held the ball for the next... Wow.
He's got 3.4. Didn't look like anything went his way.
Don't say that either.
I can two rail the 9, stick to the back here.
He can cut the 6.
What?
Yeah, what? I like him to use a bridge, though.
I like him to play something safer. When you're on your last barrel, I don't want to be cutting the 6.
Here he goes.
He's just playing it safe. No, he got it.
Tony playing safe? No, he's trying to make
yeah,
it.
Yeah, but look at where he's up to cue ball. Nice. Now Warren's in trouble.
He's in deep doo-doo.
Tony's got 4 balls and 1 hanging. Warren's got trouble. Although Warren's coming around and he's going to look at that 9-3. Look at the 9-3. He's going for it. He overcut the room rent.
Yeah, he did.
But he's still winning 2-0. But now he's going to be winning 2-1.
It's going to—it's about to be 2-1.
And it's Tony's break.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, fell in.
Didn't quite want that, but.
No, he got 6. But this is like the last one he banked.
He can stiff this relatively safely. He won't even have to worry about.
I think he's got to roll it selling like he rolled out. That other one. He needs 2 balls. Yeah, I like it when he rolls them.
Tony's looking for 1 ball. 1 point, probably play this off the 1. The 2 ball off the 1. What do you think? You like that shot, Carla?
I don't like anything when you got gambling going, you need 1 ball. I think you should roll the 11 to the rail or something. That's what I think.
Actually, I don't think it goes off the 1. It looks like the 5's in the way. He may physically have to cut this ball.
But what if you scratch and
it came off the 5, see? I didn't
see,
like
now
it.
Now you give Warren a chance to do something.
I didn't like it because the five was in the way. Didn't even, I don't even know.
Yeah, anyway, he needs one. Warren yep. needs them all. But Warren can cut this four in, put the bring the cue ball back where he's at. Warren's got a quiet little stroke, doesn't he? Oh, look at that. He sold out the 12. I never thought he would be way over there. He didn't plan on that, I don't think.
He's too straight on this 11. It's almost like not worth shooting at it.
No, I thought he was going to bring the cue ball back over that way so he could do the same thing with the 12.
To the 12, you know? Yeah. But he came two rails, almost the third rail across.
Well, he needs them all, so he could two rail the 13. You know what I mean?
Yep. Eddie Cohen. Eddie Cohen asks if that's Carla with me. Yep.
Hey, Eddie.
Carla says hi.
So, Eddie, you were up in Fremont, huh?
Yeah, he's supposed to be here as well.
Oh, okay.
He's supposed to be here. He'll be here on Friday, I believe, or maybe tomorrow.
Come on down now, Eddie. There's going to be big action tonight.
Yeah. So, Warren got a ball out of that run. And Tony is breaking.
All right. It's 2-2. 2-2, right?
It is 2-2. No, it's 2-1.
Didn't Tony just win two games?
No.
Is that the first game he won?
The first game he won.
Oh, and he's breaking, yeah.
Yeah.
2-1, Tony breaking.
2-1, Tony breaking, and we are at Freezer's Ice House. It's the Freezer's Ice House One Pocket Challenge. Streaming live from Freezer's. Come on down. 83 East Broadway Road, Tempe, Arizona, zip code 85282. Open late tonight, because we're probably going to be playing out late matches late tonight.
What time do you think the last matches will be? What time were the last matches last night?
There were no last matches last night. Those are going to be Trace Kane questions and Junior Flores questions.
But you usually have one at like I'm thinking 10.
I'm thinking our last match maybe as late as 11 o'clock tonight.
Oh, starting at 11?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So you're going to go late then.
Like I said, we're playing late tonight because we've got 52 players.
What time do you start tomorrow?
11? How many players we got? 52?
51.
51? Yeah, 51 players in the one pocket?
That's right.
52
heard.
Players.
52?
Somewhere around there, playing on 12 tables.
What time did you start today in the
so
morning?
So you do the math. We
what?
Tried to start at 9 a.m., but we ended up around 10 a.m.
Oh, that's still 9:30. Pretty early.
Yeah.
You're still playing at 11 o'clock.
Yeah.
There's not 8 hours in between there.
So I want to especially thank West 8 Billiards and all of our sponsors for
heard Tony go to the bathroom.
Stepping up, sponsors of the West Coast Swing. I don't know where he is. We'll be right back.
Hi, I'm Donnie Wessels with West 8 Billiards. Do you know we have been servicing the West Coast for over 70 years? We have just about everything you need for your game room. Arcades, poker tables, pool tables, shuffle boards, spectator chairs, air hockey, foosball, and have you seen the new Gold Crown 6 from Brunswick? Call us at 1-800-266-8914.
West8Billiards.com.
Hi, I'm Donnie Wessels with West 8 Billiards and Game Rooms. West 8 is more than just pool tables. We are the whole game room. We sell arcades, shuffle boards, game tables, pub tables, bars, bar stools, game chairs, foosballs, air hockey, table tennis. And with companies like California House and Olhausen, everything can match, making game rooms beautiful enough to be in your living room. So put down your cell phone and let's play some games. Call us at 1-800-266-8914.
West8Billiards.com.
Yeah, we also want to thank Big Time Threads. for stepping up and sponsoring the West Coast Swing. Big time, Threads. You can buy a West Coast Swing t-shirt if you like at bigtimethreads.com, or you can come to Freezer's Ice House and pick it up in person. Just go to bigtimethreads.com/limited-edition-merchandise. Something like that. Limited-edition-merch. So we're back, and we saw Tony scrape a game out of this set against Warren Kiyomko. After losing the first two games. So the score now is 2-1. And this is Tony's break, which gives Tony the immediate upper hand.
Yeah. But it's 2-1 in the set, so he's got to win this game and then fade another of these games.
He's got to fade Warren for another game with Warren breaking. So we'll see what happens. Pool Hustler 6 says it's going to be 2-2 soon.
Yeah. Who
okay.
is Pool Hustler 6?
I don't know. First he's betting against Cho-Ann, now he's betting on him.
Well, a lot of Cho-Ann fans in Detroit.
A lot of Cho-Ann fans in Detroit.
My friend Bernie's in Detroit at Richie's pool room. What's he going to do here?
Well, let's take a look at this side of the table here.
He could follow that two all the way over to the rail. Kind of protecting the 14.
I think he can get on top of the 10 ball here and bank the 10 toward his hole.
Can he see the 10?
Yeah, he can see.
I thought the 6 was...
He can see just over a quarter of it, I think a third of it. So maybe that's not enough.
I think it's tight. I think he can see the 2.
Well, he can see all of the 2.
Yeah, just follow it over there.
It just goes the wrong way, yeah, so. Well, Tony. Tony can bank this 12. Suicide. Oh, he's got the 15 right here. 15 ball.
Oh, that's pretty to watch, isn't it?
How'd he hit it, Carla?
That is some pretty stuff. He's looking at two or three different combinations.
Hank wanted to know if that pool room you're talking about is along Jefferson in Michigan.
I don't think so. I think it's closer to Michigan and Telegraph somewhere. But I can't even remember where Jefferson is. It's been so long since I've been in Detroit.
You know, he raises his eyebrows up and down, too. You know what I mean? When he focuses on the ball?
Yeah.
His eyebrows kind of go up and down a little?
Yeah, a little bit. It's kind of cool.
Yeah. You're probably too young to remember Steve Misurak, but he was a world champion.
No, I remember him.
He was a world champion, won the straight pool U.S. Open every year, 4 years in a row. And he had a similar kind of look to Tony. Big,
yeah.
Powerful stroke, and his forehead went up and down when he was focusing on the ball. And he scared all his opponents to death.
Yeah, Misurak was, he was quite something.
He kind of overpowered everybody.
Yeah,
big stroke.
Did. Oh, he had
kinda
a huge like stroke. Huge stroke. Kind of like Tony. I think Misurak's cue ball, playing nine ball, you know, was just amazing.
Yeah. But he was a straight pool player.
Like kind of, like Buddy Hall as well, you know? Like Buddy mm-hmm. Hall was, he had the cue ball on a string.
Yeah. He's taking a foul. I don't blame him. He didn't know what to do, so he rolled him in there. 3-1 on this game. Stick him right back in the stack.
Meanwhile, Tony does have 3, so just updating the score.
Yeah, 3-1, and it's 2-1 on the set. Warren in the lead. Now what's he going to do here? What are his choices? I guess he's thinking of doubling him up, huh? He's going to try to hide him behind
yeah,
the...
not fast enough.
Well, it's okay. I mean, it's hard for him to get shape off this 13. He owes 2, and that's 2 in a row, huh?
Yes, ma'am. Hard for him to get shape, huh? Carla, do you know who the guy is playing?
I forgot about that.
Yeah.
That big stroke.
This guy knows every shot, pretty much. Wow. He went forward so he could open the stack and play for that 8. Strong.
Now he's going to come around for this 4-5 combine.
Combo. Mm-hmm.
Although it's kind of off backwards.
Don't think Tony minds that much. Seven, 11, 4. That's what I see next.
How many has he got? 1, 2, 3, 4. He only needs one.
Yep.
Or does
game.
He? 1, 2, 3.
Game
four,
ball.
Five, six,
game ball coming up. Oh, the one.
Yeah.
Carla.
It's 2-2. We got a hill game.
We got hill in like what? That took what? 12 minutes to get those last two games.
Now, but Warren is breaking.
Warren is breaking. Yes, that's right. Tony's got to fade that. Tony has to fade it.
It's a horse race.
Sure is. We got some good pool in this match. I mean, it looked like it was Warren's.
Yeah.
So looks like it was Warren's, you know?
Yeah. Well, he's still in it.
The noise is beginning to swell in here.
Yeah. Well, there's so many TVs in here, too. There's like 100 TVs.
Something like that.
There's a full bar.
I think it's like 75 TVs.
They got like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 dart boards.
Yes. And then they got four more
and they're kind
non-electric
of like,
boards.
They're
kind of
like off to one side, so it's cool that you can't... they're throwing the darts away from the pool part, you know?
Yeah.
Arizona State is right here, so this is a big college area. Okay, Warren can see the two. Will he bank the two and put the cue ball back in the stack?
He might. That's exactly what he did, Carla.
Yep. Yep, and he got him hooked on the four, so he can't get back there easily.
And you know it's hard when you got a ball on either side, on either
got
rail.
Up and down, huh?
Up and down. So that makes it real tough.
Well, he's just the man for the job.
Well, he might just bump this five away. Well, you can't just bump the five away and leave him in the stack because he can bank the eight. He's going to have to do something here. What's he doing? He's going to double up the 14-15. I don't like that because the 15 looks pretty easy to combo in.
I don't know because the side box is there. I think it's a good thing if you can double him up. So he's going to go off the 8, shove it toward his hole more, and...
And then double him up.
Or he can roll out between, you know, kick one, two rails and try to get on the 15, roll up and hit the 15.
And now he's looking at... He wants the two rail into the 15 direct. Like that.
Well, that's hard. I don't know why he did it hard.
He wanted to hit the other side of it.
Yeah.
I believe.
Well,
I don't know.
Now we got a sweat Warren trying to run out.
Yeah. There's
nothing on his side, but he's got...
Warren's got a sweat Warren.
The world has to sweat Warren running out. It's nothing to nothing. Made one.
And
got nothing.
Yeah.
Well, it wasn't you know.
He could have gone up for the 14,
yeah,
and then he could have come back down for the 8.
Yes, and that probably would have been.
I think that would have been better. Well, obviously, look where he is now.
And he probably would have done that playing anybody but Tony. But Tony makes them think that they got to run out to win, you know. All right, what's he going to do here? Can he kick the 8? Is he kicking the 8? Yeah, he can only see enough to kick it. Can he see the 15 to bank it? And draw it up?
Not sure, Carla. He's He's stepped away from it, so.
Wait for something better. Somebody has one ball. Who has one ball?
Warren does.
Warren has one
he
ball.
Shot that, remember, when he could have
yeah.
could have came up for the 14.
Yeah. Like this 4-12 is kind of deadish, isn't it? In Warren's hole. I don't know what he can do here except just skim off the four. Plus he wants to kick into the stack. What would be wrong with kicking into the stack? You know what I mean? It's a nice little pocket there. Just hit the 10-7.
The catcher's mitt.
Yeah.
Right into the 7.
So, Tom Worth played in the tournament up there, huh?
Yeah. I don't necessarily like the shot. I like actually what Warren's doing now because
he's got all the balls on Tony's side now.
You can't necessarily go into that catcher's mitt and guarantee that Tony's not going to have something to bank at, you know? Especially Tony, come on.
But I mean, if you stick it to the pack, well, we'll see. Look what he did. He does some of the damnedest shots.
Look, and it didn't hurt him either.
Well, he got lucky that
got the 9 close to.
He got lucky that those 3 or 4 balls on Warren's side stuck together. Yeah, he thinks of a way to get something by his hole, doesn't he? Now, how's Warren going to get behind the 9? I don't know. Unless he thins off the 7. What's he doing? Oh, what's he doing?
He's playing a safe cue ball, and he was trying to shoot the 4-15
wow.
combo.
Wow. How cool is that, except for look how close he came to the side. Now, what's Tony going to play? Some wacko combine. Here he comes with a billiard. 13 off the 10. Oh, he can cut it? Maybe he can cut it. No problem. Let's cut it in. Of course, now he's got another 3-ball combination. Well, it's 1-1. Look at these balls on Warren's side, how funny they are. How did they get like that? Looks like a wedge on Warren's side.
You Yeah, that wedge has been forming.
Well, he looks like he's winding up to do something. Can you see the 14? Oh, I could see the 14. Perfect. Warren's in deep trouble again.
And who would have thunk, you know?
Yeah, right off the edge of the wedge came the 14.
Warren up 2-0 in this match, and now it's like... It's like Warren's looking down the barrel of a gun right now.
Yep. Yeah, this is like check. Tony's got balls on his side, open and wide. Warren's got to do something tricky. What can you play off the four and just try to make the 14?
That's all he can try to do. Yeah, play
if
off
he
the
does that, I mean, then Tony has a five straight back. Or
I don't know if Warren might be eyeballing like a straight bank to his hole, but I don't see any.
I don't see any. The 11 is going to hit either the 9 or the 4. He needs to make that 14, and then he'll still be in trouble.
Well,
he could shoot the 11 straight into the 14, follow the cue ball over there. He's a good billiard player, so he could just billiard it off the 4.
See, you've said it twice already, a billiard player. I didn't know Warren was a billiard player.
All the Filipinos are good billiard players. That's what they learn.
He's freezing to the stack.
Well, what a great shot.
Was it, though? He's not very happy. He's nodding his head.
Madeline Whitlow just stepped into the booth.
All right.
They're listening, they're watching this in Detroit and LA.
Just those two places?
So this is the best player in the world, Tony Chohan.
Oh, this is over. Yeah. Carla, this is over.
Yeah. This is Hill.
I mean,
race to three.
I hate to be the, I hate to predict, but...
Yeah.
Yeah,
the Filipino sitting down was ahead 2-0, and Tony, the best player, finally got up and started winning, and now he needs to run out. Doesn't he look like Mizorak? Watch him shoot. His forehead starts to go up and down.
His eyebrows. There go the eyebrows. I'm looking at the eyebrows now. Tony needs 4. They're all sitting pretty right there. Holy simoleons.
What's he going to do here? Pull it over for the 12?
No, he float over for the 4.
Okay. How many does he need?
He needs 2 balls. Oh, he's drawing out into the 7.
Oh, boy, he got lucky.
Drama.
He got lucky. He didn't leave Warren straight in.
Wow.
Well.
Someone just turned up the heat.
6-1. Tony's got one hanging. He got lucky. He didn't leave Warren straight in. This is Scott Frost's new pool room. Nice, huh?
Yeah. Opened up a year ago. Just over a year now, I think. No, wait. They're coming on 2 years already or something.
You know what I like the best is the lights over the pool room. I mean, over the pool table. Those are fluorescent. Or those are, yeah.
LED.
LED.
This is still like, This is the same situation Warren was in just a minute ago.
It isn't like Warren can't find his way out of it, but
how do you fade this situation right here?
Tony was so lucky he didn't leave Warren straight in on the 11. I guess you got to make that 15 for him. That's all. Play the billiard.
Maybe with the 7.
Oh, he missed the billiard.
Missed.
Well, that's all she wrote.
That's, yeah. I hate to say it. Pool Hustler 6 says, I'll take Warren from here. Okay.
For how much?
Yeah, for how much? We could make a lot of money on this delayed stream, you know?
Oh, is it delayed?
It is a little bit.
Fast post them.
Yeah.
Tony Chohan.
Tony
wins the
Chohan
match.
Takes it, and who would have thunk it?
What a comeback.
Yeah, 3-2 from a 0-2 deficit, and Warren is probably disgusted.
Well, he had two tough matches in a row, and he won the first one. He'd probably like to sit down. Well, I got to stand up. Daniel,
Carla, thanks
fun.
For doing these two matches with me. It's been so much fun.
Yeah.
And I know you got company now, so, and I look forward to meeting her too. I know you have.
This is Madeline Whitlow, Madeline Roberts. Used to be Madeline Whitlow, the pool champion. This is Daniel Bush.
Nice to meet you. Madeline, would you like to say something to people out there that might be watching? Can I just put the handheld on you and say hello to you?
Well, hello to you. I'm not going to sing New York, New York or anything. It's just a pleasure to be here and see that there's a great pool room here in Tempe in this Phoenix metropolitan area, and that Scott Frost has got it. So this is wonderful news, because I was afraid there wasn't much pool here in town, and this is very hopeful. Thank you.
You're welcome, Madeline. I'm very honored to meet you, and you know, I've heard so much about you, and I know that you're. I know that you probably could sing something for us right now if we wanted, because you're an accomplished musician. So, I'm gonna catch up and get acquainted a little bit with Madeline, and we're gonna be back with something. Very soon. Coming up next in about 10 minutes, folks, we've got Derek Pergursky versus Scott Frost right here on POV Pool. Keep watching and keep loving pool.